Mark Roy-Tony, and I'm a professor here at the University of Minnesota, and I have my own lab at HCMC of Minneapolis. I'm here to present AgVax, which is a concept for a company that is invested in development of vaccines for drug addiction. Why drug addiction? So as you probably know, right now the U.S. is facing one of the biggest crises in terms of opioid abuse and overdose. So tens of thousands of people die every year from overdoses from compounds like heroin, OxyContin, and heroin contaminated with fentanyl. So there are a few medications out there, but only one out of five patients actually receive them. So there is definitely room for improvement. So we propose here is to develop vaccines to target abuse of these opioids and possibly prevent overdose. So the concept here is pretty simple. Vaccines will elicit antibodies that will block and prevent opioids effect. We have demonstrated efficacy and safety in animal models, and obviously this approach can offer benefits over current therapies. We've been doing this for a while from an academic standpoint, and so we passed the discovery phase. We went through IND meetings to have ensure a regulatory path. We are at the late stage development, and we are getting ready to actually do clinical trials. And off of this particular platform, we have developed other pipeline of products like monoclonal immunomodulators. And through the process, we have raised in the last 5 years more than $10 million in non-dilutive capital, that is NIH grants. So right now we have received a lot of attention from media. Also, the UGAP was very generous in putting us through the Ribbon Discovery platform, and also the time is now right, like, to fund a company around this to apply for SBIRs, since the NIH has put a lot of funding for this. And so the team is actually composed of very experienced people. We've also been approached by potential pharma partners, and as you can see here, we have more of a consortium than a team. Science per se, I think that going after NIH funds is probably the most strategic aspect, also because we need quite a bit of funding. So far I mentioned that 10 million, but now we're asking about like 20 million to a phase one to NIH. If you get that, obviously we can go forward, and for phase two we'll need more. But what I really would like probably is more of a infrastructure to actually start the company. I'm pretty well spent, so like as you can imagine, I have other aspects of my job that gives me a busy. So this, like, I kind of want to have like a little more of infrastructure to start the company so that we can actually apply for the SBIR, SBDR, and Sprint. We have some idea around this technology, but Sprint kind of like an IP bundle, so include both compositional matter, but also methods of use and so forth, and kind of that's all. So we do things like marketing analysis, but I do that to essentially either friends or colleagues that are actually been doing that out in the real world, and so, or we benefit from resources, like for example, we have here some mentorship from either like Carla Pavone or like other people at Iran, so the environment is proper for this. And also, so I would say that I think back about to make this into something more than just like an academic venture. So not so much for like the commercialization aspect itself alone, but just to get, as you can imagine, you need like so much money to push it all.
Yep. So the patient now, though, will never again, if immunized, get therapeutic benefit from these opioids. They're now going to have to use Advil, Tylenol, things like that.
That's partially correct. So these vaccines are very selective. So for example, if you're immunizing against oxycodone, you can still use like codeine and so forth. Or if your problem is like you're a heroin user at risk of dying of fentanyl, those other like oxycodone and so forth can be spared off. Also antibodies, once you stop immunizing, they actually drop off, and so eventually you can go back to be like sort of opioid free, and you can still use opioids despite being the vaccine. But if you relapse, for instance, you get a reboosted, and this antibody levels get up and go. So it could be somewhat personalized to the type of patients. It also could be combined, but I spend a lot of time to show that this thing can be combined with either Unitrol, Narcan, and all the products out there, so they actually can be brought on like in standard clinical setting.
Ask me if your patent or your intellectual property shows it's MMRF, not Advax. How does Advax, what rights
well,
do
Advax
have?
Well, Advax is not registered. I actually, like, I want to start Adivax, so that I can apply for, so right now.
So you would have to get a license.
Yes, that's correct. Like, so the patent and also the funding, like NIH, we're funding under the eye, and also I'm the inventor, but all the funding went to MMRF.
Mm-hmm.
So that's correct.
Okay.
So, but there is a patent license to that. So. Thank you.